Bloating is when your belly feels full after eating and filled with air or gas. Excessive gas production is a common symptom, causing patients to seek advice from medical health professionals. Patients may attribute with abdominal cramps, bloating, chest discomfort, audible bowel sounds, belching, flatulence, and gaseousness. Now we will see the composition and volume of the intestinal gas. Main gases in the flatus are oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, methane, and carbon dioxide. Oxygen and nitrogen come from swallowed air. Hydrogen, methane, and carbon dioxide come from intestinal lumen. Hydrogen, methane produce as a result of bacterial metabolism. Carbon dioxide can be bacterial fermentation of the dietary products. Excretion of flatus averages about 600 ml per day. Now we will do the clinical assessments of a patient presented to us with bloating. First of all, history and examination is very important. In history, first of all, we will see the diet. If patient is taking legumes, beans, apples, prunes, raisins, and starches, then these can be fermented and results in the gas production. Then comes the medication history. If patient is taking narcotics like opiates, morphine, or oxycodone, these can cause narcotic bowel syndrome. Analgesics and calcium channel blockers also play an important role. Past surgical history is very important, as if 25 to 50% patients experience gas bloating after a recent fundoplication procedure. And as well as psychiatric history, anxiety and depression can be the relevant in this cause. And systemic diseases like diabetes mellitus. In diabetes, gastroparesis occurs due to the autonomic neuropathy. And in scleroderma, altered motility due to the neuromuscular dysfunction. And next disease is muscular dystrophy, and then the hypothyroidism. These all can be the important causes. Then physical examination to look the signs of the weight loss, air swallowing, ascites, anxiety, and peritonitis, and also look for succession splash. To examine this sign, gently shake the abdomen by holding either side of the pelvis. A positive test occurs when splashing noise is heard either through the naked ear or with stealth. This test is not valid if patient has eaten or drunk fluid within the last 3 hours. Now, management of the patient with the bloating. First of all, reassure the patient that air swallowing is a very common. And if patient is habitual of gum chewing, stop smoking, and acid suppression can be helpful by either using H2 blockers or PPIs. Bacterial overgrowth may need treatment. Most important thing is dietary modifications. Now, decrease the intake of legumes, beans, fruits, and decrease intake of complex carbohydrates can be helpful. Next, activated charcoal, if taken orally before a meal, can reduce breath hydrogen. Some patients may have delayed intestinal transit, can be constipated. Treatment with increased dietary fiber or non-stimulant osmotic laxative, not lactulose, can relieve the constipation in these patients. Now, at the end, there is preliminary evidence that some probiotic bacteria like Bifidobacter infantis present in a product called VSL3 may alleviate symptoms of bloating in inflammatory bowel syndrome patients.